What's good, guys? It's Bree here from Neighbourhood. Are you trying to automate processes but are struggling to set up actions and workflows? Well, you might need to learn to master the workflow tool in HubSpot. Today, we're going to go over how to select the right actions and add them into your workflows in HubSpot. If you want to take today's lesson offline, we'll include a free downloadable PDF in the description below. So as usual, we're starting on our homepage in our HubSpot portal. And for workflows, we're very lucky to have a tab already called workflows. So we're going to go straight there. So before you start creating your workflow, we usually recommend having a goal in mind. So we're going to have a think about that before I run through the different actions we're going to use in the automation. To start off with, we're going to create a workflow. So we'll go over to the right here and click create a workflow. From here, you can either start from scratch or use a template. If we have a quick look at the templates, you can see HubSpot have created heaps to help you get started if you're not feeling too comfortable starting from scratch. But for today, we are going to start from scratch so I can show you all the different actions you can use within HubSpot automation. So I'm going to click here, create from scratch. And this is going to ask us what we want our trigger to be based on. So we have a couple of different triggers. We have contact, we have company, deal base, which would specifically probably be used for any sales processes, ticket base, which is used for any service processes, quote based, conversation based, feedback, subscription, payment, and it goes on and on. For today, we're just going to use contact based as this is a very easy way to get started and into HubSpot automation. So I'm going to click contact based and I'm just going to do a blank workflow for now. You can also trigger your workflow on a schedule, on a specific date, or using a contact date property. These can all be useful, and once again, you need to have a goal in mind to know which one to use. So for today, we're just going to use blank workflow. So now that we've moved on from the setup, you can see here that we've got our workflow and automation space. There's a couple of different tabs up here that we'll go through, and also the settings and goals that we'll go through as well. So a couple things to note before we get started is over on the left here. So when those workflows get quite big, you might not be able to see everything on the screen. So you can zoom in and out up here on the left, or you can use the mini map for those massive workflows or automations. To get started, before you do anything, you want to set a goal for your workflow. Where do you want your contact to get to? What's the purpose? So we're gonna go over here to the left and we're gonna set a goal. For this one, we're gonna pretend that we're trying to get our contact from a marketing qualified lead to a sales qualified lead. So in here, I'm gonna look for the lifecycle stage. And my goal is for them to reach a sales qualified lead. I'm then going to click apply filter and save. So basically once they hit this goal, they're not needed in this workflow anymore and they'll be unenrolled. Another important thing to do is to name your workflow. You can build up quite a lot of automation and workflows once you start getting into it. So make sure you have a good naming technique under your belt. So this one, we're going to use the lifecycle stage. So marketing qualified lead to sales qualified lead. From there, we want to set up the trigger. So when do we want this person to enroll into this workflow and go through the different stages and automation? So I'm going to click up set up triggers. Now from here, I want these people to go into the workflow once they've become a marketing qualified lead. So I'm going to go to lifecycle stage and click marketing qualified lead, and I want the purpose of this workflow to nurture them through and get them to a sales qualified lead position. Another thing you can also do with the triggers is go to lists. So if you want specific people in a list to get through to a sales qualified lead, such as webinar attendees or contacts that you've gotten through different types of content, we can find them here. For this one, I'll just use HubSpot test list that we have in here. and apply filter. When you're doing this, just be careful because you have and or rules. So I like to read it out to myself when I'm checking. And once we're done, I'm just gonna click save. So this is the fun bit. We get into the different actions for a workflow. So I'm gonna click this plus. And this plus here is gonna do the new action, the next action, and it's gonna keep going until we get to the end. So let's just run through some of the available actions that HubSpot has on offer. The first group that we're looking at is delay. So you can delay for a set amount of time. For example, if you want the contact to wait a couple of days before they get a certain email, you can use delay for a set amount of time. You can also delay until a date happens. So this is specifically useful for any seasonal workflows you have coming up. You can also get them to enroll in another workflow or another automation. You can use custom code as well. We'll get into the if branches in a second. And then it gets into communication. So we have internal communication if you want to send a notification for someone within the team that's relevant to this workflow. So that might be the sales team or the service team. We also have external communication, which is outwards communication towards your customers and client base. So you can send them an email, enroll them in a sequence, which is within the sales tools in HubSpot, or even send a WhatsApp message. If you have any integrations with your HubSpot account, you can sometimes find them in the workflow tool. That's if their integration allows for that. So you can see Salesforce has an integration in here. You can also set an assignment and also manage your records. So you can create a new company or a new deal based on the workflow automation. Finally, moving down to the last lot of actions, we can add them to a static list. We can add them to an ads audience for ad management. And there's also some property management as well. So if they run through the workflow, we can change or set their property values. So let's get into doing an example and see how these different actions come into play. So as I mentioned, I want this workflow to get someone from a marketing qualified lead to a sales qualified lead. So I might use a couple of emails. I'll definitely use the delay actions as well. And I might use an if-then branch as well. So to start with, let's send an email to our marketing qualified lead. From here, you can search for an email, and this is great if you have named your emails correctly and well with a good naming technique in mind. For this one, we'll do the email number one. Let's click save. So for a quick example to see how this workflow works, we've had a person enroll as a marketing qualified lead, then they're gonna go to the next step, and they're going to get this email automatically without you having to send it or anything like that. We're now gonna add another action. So once again, this is gonna come after the email. Now we don't wanna send them another email straight away because that might seem like we're spamming them or annoying them. So let's delay it for a little bit. So I'm gonna click delay for a set amount of time. And I'm gonna leave it for about 5 days. And then I'm gonna click save. So what's happening here is the person is going to qualify for this workflow by becoming a marketing qualified lead. They're going to be sent an email and then they're going to sit in that email for 5 days before the next action. And for the next action, we'll do another email. Now let's say from here that some people have clicked on our CTA within the email and some people haven't. We may need to nurture those people who haven't clicked on the CTA a little bit more. So what I'm going to do here is actually create an if and then branch. And this is going to split our users who started from this same trigger into two different groups. So in one group, I'm going to go to marketing emails. I'm going to find the email we just sent to them, and I'm going to say that the contact has clicked a link in the email. So now we have two branches here. We have one group that's clicked a link within the email and one group that hasn't. From here, we can continue to add different types of actions and get them to where they need to go. On branch one, we don't really need to do much more nurturing as they seem to be clicking and engaging in our emails. So from here, I'm going to send another email. And on the other side of the branch, I might do something a little different. I might still do an email, but just make sure that that email is targeted towards this specific group. So that's our workflow for now. Just remember that when you're creating an email, you do need to set them up and make sure they're set up for automation. We're going to move forward from here. So let's go onto the next part of the workflow tool, which is the settings. Whenever I'm setting up a workflow, I like to go into settings just to make sure that everything's perfect as it is automated, and you want to make sure that the workflow is acting exactly how you want it to act. So what times do I want the actions to execute? For this one, I'm going to do specific times. I only want them to send emails between working hours. I don't want them sending at 1 a.m., for example. With that said, if you do have contacts from around the world, like in the US, but you're Australian time like us, you might do any time just so it doesn't mess with that time difference there. From here, you can also select a campaign so you can track and report on the success of your workflow as well. You may also want to unenroll or suppress people from getting into this specific workflow. And you can also remove them from other workflows when they come into this workflow as well. Finally, we have notifications as well. So if you want to be notified when people come into this workflow, you can. If we go to the next tab, we can have a look at the goals as well and see how well you're tracking for your goals. So for this one, for example, we did sales qualified leads. So we want to see the conversion rate from marketing qualified lead to sales qualified lead. Right now, we don't have any data to show, so we won't be looking at this one just yet. Finally, the last tab is all the different types of changes for workflows. This is super important. Just in case something goes wrong or something changes, you can go back, have a look, and see what might have been updated. Now, before you go ahead and set your workflow live, you do want to test it. So this is a great little feature where you can preview the workflow and how someone may go through the workflow as well. You can use real contacts from your CRM to see how this workflow may play out for them. Once you've tested it, you're going to click review. The review panel is super helpful just in case there's any errors within your workflow. For example, steps 5 and 6 need a quick change, so I'm going to go down to there. And as you can see, there's a little warning sign. The changes needed is that I need to add an email. So I'll just quickly do that. Let's try review again. So when you get to this panel, just make sure that you go through everything on this list. So the first thing is, do you want to enroll existing contacts? In some purposes, you may want to, in some you may not. So just review that goal that you started with from the beginning. Scrolling down, we're checking when a contact actually enrolls into the workflow, whether or not they can be re-enrolled into the workflow, and the different types of connections within this workflow as well. For this workflow, I don't want any existing contacts to go into this workflow. And once you're done, all you need to click is turn on. And there we have it. You now know how to choose the right actions and add them to your workflows in HubSpot. If you're after a PDF version of what you've learned today, we'll leave a link in the description as well. If you've learned something new from this video and you're keen to learn out more about HubSpot, make sure to give us a like, subscribe, and hit that bell icon so you never miss another video. That's all from me, guys. Happy HubSpotting.